अस्सलाम वालेकुम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस मैटलैब सिमुलिंक ट्यूटोरियल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू अप्लाई रेडियल बेसिस फंक्शन न्यूरल नेटवर्क विथ वेवलेट ट्रांसफार्म फॉर पावर सिस्टम फॉल्ट आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड क्लासिफिकेशन। फ्रेंड्स, इट इज़ बेटर टू हाईलाइट हेयर दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेड अ वीडियो ऑन हाउ टू अप्लाई वेवलेट ट्रांसफार्म फॉर पावर सिस्टम फॉल्ट आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड क्लासिफिकेशन इन मैटलैब सिमुलिंक सॉफ्टवेयर। इन दिस वीडियो आई डिस्कस द एप्लीकेशन एज वेल एज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ वेवलेट ट्रांसफार्म इन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फॉल्ट इन द पावर सिस्टम। The main limitation was that wavelet transform depends upon the threshold value to classify the different types of fault in power system. Furthermore, it was also discussed that this threshold value is not generalized and cannot be used for all types of power system. Therefore, to overcome this limitation, computational intelligence based techniques such as artificial neural network and its various types can be used. Friends, I have already made the videos on artificial neural network series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Artificial Neural Network in MATLAB Simulink. This ANN series consists of four parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series for better understanding if you want. Let's discuss how to apply radial basis function neural network with wavelet transform for classification of faults. It may be noted that accuracy of the artificial neural network depends upon the input and output data. Larger the data, higher will be the accuracy and vice versa. It means that we must have sufficient amount of input and output data for better accuracy of the radial basis function neural network. To do this, we need to simulate all types of faults in the Simulink and determine their coefficients using the wavelet transform as we did in the wavelet transform video. Let me show you again how to get the wavelet coefficients of all the three phase currents and ground current. Let's consider the basic Simulink model of simple power system as shown here. It may be noted that three phase to ground fault is applied near the voltage source. To determine its wavelet coefficients, we need to use MATLAB program as shown here. Now let's run the program by clicking on the display button. You can see MATLAB program has successfully provided the wavelet detailed coefficients of all three phase currents and ground current. These four variables are basically the input data of radial basis function neural network. Therefore, save all these four values in a table as shown here to collect the input data. Similarly, repeat all types of faults at this position and calculate the wavelet coefficient in all cases and save all the values in this table as shown here. It means that by doing this way, we will have 12 input data cases. For better accuracy, we must have input data of at least 100 cases or higher. Friends, if the power system size is large, then 100 input data cases can be easily obtained. Suppose consider the single line diagram of IEEE 9 bus system. In this system, if we apply all 12 fault conditions at each bus, still we can generate 108 cases. Now if we change the fault ground resistance and again apply all 12 fault conditions at each bus, another 108 input data cases can be obtained. Furthermore, we can vary the fault ground resistance and can generate 1000 input data cases. Now come to our model again. As it is very small power system model, the main purpose of this model is to just share the idea. Therefore, we can obtain at least 100 plus cases by applying all 12 fault condition before the transmission line, as well as after the transmission line position, and by changing the fault ground resistance. Let me show you one such example here, in which I have applied the fault after the transmission line, and also I have changed the fault ground resistance as shown here. Now let's run the program by clicking on this play button. You can see MATLAB program has successfully provided the wavelet detailed coefficient of all three phase current and ground current. Therefore, save all these four values in a table as shown here to collect the input data. For your convenience, I have simulated all the fault conditions and have collected 138 input data cases in the form of table as shown here. Friends, I will share the link of this table in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. Now let's prepare the output data of all these 130 input cases. In order to classify all types of fault, we need the output signal for each phase current as well as for ground current. Therefore, in total, we need four output variables. In the power system, either system is normal or subjected to the fault condition. We can represent the normal output condition by assigning 0 integer and 1 as fault condition to distinguish between the faults. Now come to input data cases. In the first case, it is observed that 3 phase to ground fault is simulated. Therefore, the output of each phase and ground current will be 1 as shown here. Similarly, for double line to ground fault between phase A, B and ground, only phase A, B and ground output will be 1 to represent the faulty condition, and phase C will be assigned 0 value to represent the normal condition. Similarly, we have to assign the output value to each phase current and ground current depending upon the type of fault. For your convenience, I have assigned the output values to each phase current and ground current of all these 138 cases according to the type of fault in the form of table as shown here. At this stage, we have defined the input and output data for the radial basis function neural network. Now we have to divide this input and output data again in two parts, namely training data and testing data. We have in total 138 cases. The normal ratio to divide the data into training and testing is 70% and 30% respectively. However, as a rough estimate, I have chosen 30 cases for testing purpose and remaining 108 cases for training purpose. It means that we will not use these 30 cases in the training process. After the successful training, we will test the performance of the radial basis function neural network for these unseen 30 cases. If neural network classifies correctly, its efficiency will be 100% or little bit lesser if it fails to detect in few cases. Now question may arise how to divide the data into training and testing data. For better accuracy, it is recommended that training data must contain some cases closely related to the testing data. Otherwise, its accuracy will be low. Keeping in view this consideration, I have randomly selected these cases for training data and these cases for testing data. In testing data, we will use only the input variables and the radial basis function neural network will provide their output. In the end, we will compare those outputs with these actual outputs to determine its efficiency. Let's create this input and output training data in MATLAB. For this purpose, go to Workspace section and right-click anywhere on it. Click on New to create new variable. Now right-click on it and give it name as Input. Now double click on it, a new window will open. Now come to table and copy these input 4 variables of all 108 cases and paste it here. You can see the input training data of all 108 cases are inserted here. Now we need to insert the output training data. For this purpose, go to Workspace section again and right click anywhere on it. Click on New to create new variable. Now right click on it and give it name as output. Double click on it, a new window will open. Now come to table and copy these output 4 variables of all 108 cases and paste it here. You can see the output training data of all 108 cases are inserted here. At this stage, the input and output training data for radial basis function neural network is completed. Let's create the variable for testing data in MATLAB. For this purpose, go to workspace section again and right click anywhere on it. Click on new to create new variable. Now right click on it and give it name as testing data. Now double click on it. A new window will open. Now come to table and copy these input 4 variables of all 30 cases and paste it here. You can see the input testing data of all 30 cases is inserted here. We will use this testing data of all 30 cases to test the performance of the radial basis function neural network after its successful training. Friends, due to the limitation of time, I will discuss all the next steps of this topic in the second part of this video. In the next video, I will discuss the following points: how to train the radial basis function neural network based upon this input and output training data. After successful training, how to test the performance and accuracy of radial basis function neural network for all 30 cases. Last, how to use this model for master or PhD degree research objectives. For your convenience, I have uploaded the PDF, input, output, training and testing data, as well as the Simulink model and required MATLAB programs in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.